It's not just a bridge. It holds the space. And it frames views.
People were starting to talk about Edmonton in a different way.
Edmonton was pursuing the Expo bid, a vision for turning the Rossdale generating station into an Expo site. So it allowed our imaginations to kind of have free rein about what this part of the city could be about.
Yeah, that location is so special. It's close to where Laurier brought Alberta into Confederation. So it has a significance for the city.
Long Indigenous history.
Yeah, thousands of years.
Even though we weren't successful in getting the Expo bid, I think it planted a seed in everybody's mind about the powerful potential of a bridge.
So as bridge engineers, we were very excited to work on the project. It gave us an opportunity to do something special for Edmonton. And so in addressing the project, we decided to look at several different alternatives for the bridge. We had a girder bridge option, which was a little bit more elaborate. We had a cable stayed alternative with a really tall tower that didn't seem appropriate. We had an extra dose bridge, and then we had the arch.
You know, DIALOG put together some representation to see what could be there, what, you know, could be done within the budget, and we came up with this design. And I think council wanted to have something, you know, somewhat expansive in the sense of height and dimension, which was, I think, very well received by council.
So once we completed the schematic design phase, we went into the more detailed design phase and we looked at various arch alternatives for the bridge, from a very simple arch bridge to a more complex one. And we selected the one that had the shared use path on the east side of the bridge as a separate way for people to cross. So we went through the design and we solved the engineering challenges, but as the project moved into construction, there were three things that I remember as being the most important challenges during construction. The first was the excavation that was required to put in the foundations for the arch ribs. The excavations are about 20 meters deep, which is about the same depth as a six-story parking garage. The second thing was navigating the central portion of the arch into position on the river. The arch rib was assembled on the south river bank and it was floated into place on a barge. And then the third thing was, once it was in position on berms in the water, was to hoist the arch rib into position so it was lifted up through a sophisticated arrangement that the contractor developed. My only disappointment is that the river wasn't wider and it could be longer.
I think one of the things that is really important in terms of the voice that we brought was the notion that this is a bridge for people as well as for cars. And you get that amazing sense of procession. You're coming down the hill, it curves around, and then it lines up perfectly with the bridge that then frames the view of the downtown. The sidewalk is pulled away, so you're floating over the water, and it gives you a very different experience. Really lovely urban and nature kind of coming together on the two sides of the bridge. The bridge underside becomes a really important visual element that a lot of people experience, so it was important to pay attention to it.
This is kind of a piece of architecture that's set in the middle of the river valley to create a much more dramatic scene of the importance of the river valley to the city of Edmonton, to the province of Alberta. You know, this is something that people are pretty proud of.
How many times do you go over a bridge and never think about it? This bridge, you think about it.